Hi, and welcome to Iron Strong. I'm Jeff Houser, New England District Manager. And in this episode, I'm going to be talking about external markings of ductile iron pipe. Starting off with spigot stripes, those will be found on the plain end of the pipe. These can be used as both an alignment guide as well as a homing guide. Once the spigot stripes are fully homed into the receiving bell, only then would you want to take deflection on the pipe. Now you notice on our larger diameter pipe, typically 14 inch and above, we will mark green paint on the face of the bell. That would denote a pipe that is considered gauged full length, a pipe that our quality inspectors have gauged for both ovality as well as size to accommodate cuts in the field. Pipe that is 12 inch and below, we typically do not mark with the green, which would indicate that they all are considered suitable for cutting. One item you'd want to avoid is cutting too close to the bell without measuring. So certainly, as we've talked about in past episodes, measure twice, cut once. Blue markings on the face of the bell denote a pipe that has first been zinc coated, followed by a top coat of our seal coat. Zinc coated ductile iron pipe is appropriate for corrosive environments. Talking about foundry cuts, there are typically times in a production run where we're testing pipe and we are taking a physical sample off the end of the pipe. That will require us to cut and re-bevel that pipe. Also, during the inspection process, our quality control folks may determine that a plain end is not suitable to go into a mating bell, so that pipe is trimmed. That'll be denoted with white marks or ticks on the bell face. We're permitted by the standard C151 to trim a pipe no more than 24 inches. The tick marks will note up to 6 inches. In this case, this pipe has been trimmed 18 inches. This particular pipe just been cut up to 6 inches. Pipe identification stickers. Every pipe that we manufacture at McWane Ductile will have a pipe identification sticker typically located on the bell. The pipe sticker is going to be specific for the pipe that you're receiving. So certainly the information on the sticker is going to vary depending on what you're getting and where we're shipping it from. But the basic information holds true. We're looking at the size of the pipe. In this case, it's a 20 inch, tight on joint, and it's class 55. We've double cement lined it. We have identification as far as when the pipe was finished and all the appropriate standards that our product meets. Another marking you'll see on ductile iron pipe, and this would be specific for a sewer type project, is a 401 line, Protecto 401. You'll notice on both the bell end and the plain end where this red marking occurs. Again, that denotes a pipe that's Protecto 401 lined on the interior. Another area you'll notice markings are internal markings in our bells. That'll denote the manufacturer, McWane Ductile MD, the year that the pipe was manufactured, as well as the fact that it is ductile iron pipe. You'll also notice the size of the pipe, as well as origin of manufacture, which is all of our products are proudly made in the USA. For additional information on pipe markings, please contact your local McWane Ductile sales representative. Thanks for watching this episode of Iron Strong. Until next time, work hard, work smart, and work safe.